Hey, what's going on, everybody? Continuing on here in the text project, we have finally hit the book that a lot of you have been waiting for,
the book
of Revelation. Yes, it is time to hit the crazy book of Revelation. And here's the thing. There's one important key to remember when reading the book of Revelation, and it is this important interpretive principle. Don't freak out. A lot of people freak out when they begin to read books like the book of Revelation and some different books in the Old Testament, like part of Daniel and some of Ezekiel. They just freak out. And because our brain kind of goes into reading the book of Revelation the same way we read a lot of the rest of the Bible, and that is assuming that immediately we're going to be able to grasp and understand exactly what is in this book. And Revelation is a difficult book. It's a difficult book to understand. It's kind of divided into two little categories. The first is probably one of the more popular ones. This category is where John is talking about, through this revelation he got from Jesus to an angel to John, he's talking about these warnings to some very specific churches, laying that all out. People are very familiar with that part. And then it goes into talking about the return of Jesus, which is something that we saw consistently through the New Testament is especially with like Peter talking about the return of Jesus, Paul talking about the return of Jesus, and reminding people that Jesus is one day coming back. And this is what we see in the book of Revelation. There's a lot of crazy stuff in here. Do not freak out as you're reading it. Just realize that this is talking about what is going to be happening in the end times. It's such a confusing book to so many people that, for instance, Martin Luther said that he didn't even believe that it deserved to be in the Bible. He doubted its authenticity. The reason was it disagreed with his theology. And that's why he didn't want to put it in there. There's other people who skip different parts. They don't talk about these bowls of judgment being poured out, the judgment, or they don't talk about Jesus on his throne because it disagrees with their theology. And so understand that this is a complicated book. So as you're reading it, just read it through the lens of two things. Living the kind of life that Jesus would call us to now, as we are in the end times, which began actually as soon as the church began, and the fact that one day Jesus will return. He will return to judge the living and the dead. He will return to set up his kingdom. He will return to set everything right. And so as you're reading it, just try to keep those two things in mind and don't freak out. That's the best advice that I can give to you in a few minute video. So enjoy the book of Revelation.